That's the year I was born.
So I bought two of these. The first one I bought was this guy. And, whoops, sorry about that. And you can tell, because it has the AV jack here, that AV out is a 2.5 millimeter cable that goes to two RCA, I guess one's video and one's audio. Now my problem is that my TV doesn't have RCA jacks on it, it's HDMI, or at least this TV up here. The TV downstairs does have the RCA jacks, but when I plugged it in and plugged these in, all I'm getting is a blue screen. So I didn't know what the issue was. It seemed to power on, everything seemed to be good with it, it just wasn't doing the display. So I took it apart really quick, and I was expecting to see something more advanced inside, but it's nothing special. Gotta pop these feet off, take those four screws out, and then inside is literally like a chip, a board, a green board with a couple chips on it. Nothing special. It's not like it's a Raspberry Pi or anything. Which, speaking of which, I think I'm gonna make this into my Raspberry Pi case next. So, I paid $50 for that Canadian. And then along comes this guy. Now this is the HDMI version. Same thing, paid 70 bucks though. Same game though. It comes with these funky little controllers, which I like a lot better than when I bought the actual NES Mini, because those controllers had such a short cable on them, it wasn't even funny. You can see that review hopefully here somewhere or at the end of the video. So I'm going to plug this thing in. I'm going to show you the menu and what it has. But in the meantime, let's just look at the box really quick. So this is one of the AV jacks. 600 plus games, etc., 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 which not really. Don't know why it says upgrade updated version. There's a list of all the games on the back. Wish I could read some of these. Baltron, Battle, Blink 3. It has a lot of Chinese writing up here. The boxes are completely different too. This box is really nice. It pops open, comes apart. Ugh, if I could get it open. Really nice box. This box is kind of crappy, because you have to pop it open like this to get it out. I don't really like those boxes. Anyway, it also says 600 games, HDMI 1080 version. Has all the games, once again, also listed on the back. Okay, so let's plug this thing in so you can see it. I'll turn down the volume a little bit here. And I'll try backing up the, I'll try backing up the camera to see if I can get any more of the screen in. I don't have a screen recorder or anything. Oh, such a nice long cable. See, I can pull this cable all the way back. I'm like about 5 feet back. Okay, so using the remote, I'm gonna pick English. I'm gonna press start. So here's your choices: Mario, Contra, Hot Blood, which I've never tried, the other games, Adventure, Turtle. Let's just take a quick look at Mario. Press select, which is, sorry, I press A. Super Mario Brothers, Mario 10, 16. Anything here catch your eye? Bomber Mario, Circus Mario, Mario Runner, Small Mario. Let's try some, oh, what the hell is that? Insert coin? I don't know what I'm doing. This looks like Monopoly. I'm just randomly pressing buttons and I don't know what that does. And what ticks me off about this is I don't know how to escape. Okay. So to escape, I press the reset button. which takes you back to the main menu. Let's try a different Mario, not Small Mario. Super Mario Bros. Number one. Let's try it. Hey. Okay. Well, I guess select picks between one and two. I'm going to take one. I'm going to press start. A is jump, B is fast. The graphics are kind of washed out. That seems to play okay. Ah, punk. No. Okay, well, that seems to play okay. That could keep me entertained for hours and hours and hours. Let's see what else we got on here. Contra. What the heck? Let's try the Contra 24-in-1. What the? Even more games. All right, we'll press 1. We'll select one player. Darn it. I don't know what I'm doing. I'm getting shot. I don't think I've ever played Contra before. Okay. I do not like Contra. Okay, 545-1. I'm not going to go into all these. RoboCop, Chippendale, King of Fighters, Street Fighter, Mortal Kombat, Tiny Toon, Bugs Bunny, Power Blade. I don't think that's the Angry Birds. What caught my attention earlier is I was playing Raid on Bungling Bay, which was awesome. Cliffhanger. What if they have any Star Wars games? Seems to be in alphabetical order. No, maybe not. Lupin Sansai to Side Pocket to M's. Rampage is fun. Roadrunner. Rock Ball. Silkworm. Star Wars. Let's try Star Wars. There. Jump. Oh, this game sucks. So now I'm going the other way. Instead of going 1 to 100, I'm going 545 up. Just give you an idea if there's anything. Oops, Sky Invader. I think that's like, there is a Space Invaders. Raid on Bungling Bay, which was one of my favorite games in the Commodore 64. Does not look nearly as good on here. Pac-Man, which I played, not bad. Well, maybe we'll come back and try it. I think Millipede is Centipede. Load Runner, Link, Lunar. I think Lunar Pool, Lunararian, Lunar Ball. I wonder if they have Lunar Patrol,
which I don't see. Joust. Helicopter. Hyperolympics. Let's see if it's the Hyperolympics. Looks like it. Sounds like it. So if I'm correct, you have to press A and B really fast. Whoa. I won by a hair. Anyway, that is a fun game. I'm going to be playing a lot of that. Anyway, that was my quick review of the Coolbaby. Let me know if you want me to go in depth on any of the other games that maybe it comes with. Anyway, it's a fun game. $70. This should be your Christmas gift choice for all fathers everywhere. I'm just letting you know, this is going to be like the best Christmas present you can get any father out there. So thanks for watching. I hope that we can talk again. And please subscribe. Let me know if you like these kind of videos. Oh my god, Xevious, I love this game. And I will hopefully follow up with something about it. So far, this is worth every penny. Oh my goodness. Look at this game, it's awesome.